So you did write the book, Dear Reader, on Kim Jong-il.
Yeah.
Dear Reader, the unauthorized autobiography of Kim Jong-il.
Yeah.
So that's the previous leader of North Korea.
Correct.
Current one is the
Jong-un.
No creativity on the naming.
Well, no, this is intentional because it's a throwback to the dad.
So there's been only three leaders in North Korea. So we've talked about the history of Hitler and Stalin, men like these. I think it's important to understand that the history of those kinds of humans. The history of North Korea is not well written about or understood, which is why your book is exceptionally powerful and important. So maybe in a big, broad way, can you say who is Kim Jong-il as a man, as a leader, as a historical figure that we should understand, and why should we understand them?
So I wrote Dear Reader by going to North Korea and getting all their propaganda, which is translated into several languages, because the conceit is everyone on earth is interested in them and wants to mirror their ideology.
And he died in 2011.
2011, yeah.
And you wrote the book in 2012.
I went there in 2012. The book came out in 2014. So Kim Jong-il is, though not an intellect, North Korea's version of Forrest Gump, in that when they write their history, whenever something happens, he's there. And by telling his life story, it's in the first person, he's telling the history of North Korea. So I wanted to write the kind of book where in one book, and it's the kind of reading you could do in the beach or the bathroom, you're going to get the entire history and know everything you need to know about North Korea in one accessible outlet. And it's what people don't appreciate about North Korea, there's several things. How bad it is. And this didn't happen overnight. This was very systemic, that what this family did to that country, where piece by piece, they did everything in their power to hermetically seal it from the rest of the world, ramp up the oppression, keep any information from coming in. And, you know, they're very creative and innovative in their style of manipulation and control. So there is a farcical element. Let me give you an example. So people in the West kind of get it wrong. They talk about, they talk about when Kim Jong-il played golf for the first time, he gets 17 holes in one. There's this one story about Kim Jong-il shrinking time. And this is a story of how, and it sounds supernatural, but it's not. So Kim Jong-il is at a conference, the Dear Leader, and someone is giving a talk. And while that person is giving a talk, Kim Jong-il is taking notes and working on his work. And he has an aide who keeps interrupting him with questions. And the speaker keeps stopping. And Kim Jong-il says, "Why are you stopping?" He goes, "I see you're doing these other things." And he goes, no, I can do all these things at once." Everyone's shocked. And they said, "This is why Kim Jong-il looks at time not like a plane, but like a cube. And he can shrink time." And my friend goes, "Do they mean multitasking?" And yes, Kim Jong-il is the only person in North Korea who's capable of multitasking. So in order to elevate him, they basically make everyone else in North Korea completely, you know, incompetent. And that has a purpose, because should the leader go away, this country's going to collapse overnight. So they laugh in the West about all these newspapers show him, you know, at the factory, and he's at the fish hatchery, at the paper plant. They say the difference in North Korea is that the leader goes among the people and does what he calls field guidance. So he will go in that farm and be like, "This is what you need to do." And he'll go here. And he's so smart. He's good at everything. And thanks to him for sharing his wisdom with us. And he's not removed from the people like in every other country.
Why does that seem to go wrong with humans, do you think? That this kind of the structure where there's this one figure, this authoritarian, this totalitarian structure where there's one figure that's a source of comfort and knowledge.
Kim Jong-il is not good at farming. Kim Jong-il is not good at the machinery. It's all a complete lie. Yeah. Or the things he'll point out will be things that are completely obvious. So here's another example that they use. In North Korea, they have something called the Tower of the Juche Idea, which is an obelisk, which looks like the Washington Monument, but it's completely different because it's got this like plastic torch at the top. And they talk about in their propaganda how all the architects got together and they said, we should make this the second tallest stone obelisk in the world. And Kim Jong-il says, "No, let's make it the tallest. They're like, oh, we never thought of this before. And the way it's presented as if, and like he's the first person to think of this, like these architects are having a brainstorming session, the Tower of the Juicy idea. They're like, all right, we got to do something innovative to put North Korea on the map. What can we do? How about second biggest? He's going to go for this. And then he's like, we never thought of this. It's so, because I present it at face value, people sometimes say the book's a satire. It's not a satire. I downplayed all this stuff. Mm-hmm. It's a farce. Here's another example. North Korea is very big, and I think Russia is to some extent too, on amusement parks, fun fairs, they call them in the British style, because this is the chance for the people to all get together. And there was this amusement park, it's almost like South Park, Cartman, where there's all these rides, and Kim Jong-il's like, I'm not going to let any elderly or children take these rides until I put myself in danger and ride them myself. And they go, but dear leader, it's drizzling. And he goes, no, I have to make sure these rides are going to be safe for everyone, even during the light rain. They go, well, can we go on these rides with you? No. I have to be the courageous one. And he's riding all the rides and they're standing there crying at his courage.
Yeah.
But that's what's, and you ask all the thing in one power. It's like, listen, I'm quite confident that those funfair engineers are in a position to ride Modest Mouse, whatever it's called, by themselves and be like, yeah, okay, this is good for the kids. Although to be fair, some of those amusement parks are pretty rusty and dangerous.
Yeah, but that kind of propaganda, I guess what I'm playing a devil's advocate is like, it's comforting and it's useful, but it does seem that naturally leads to an abuse of power.
But how can it be used correctly? No one person has the intellect or the mind to understand the entirety of an economy, let alone every individual field of interest.
Well, for example, you can have an artificial intelligence system that understands the entirety of it.
Your affect just completely changed. The mask slipped. Okay, I guess you could have an artificial intelligence system.
but like, the question is, can that... mean like the human version of that is like you can hire a lot of experts, right? You can be an extremely good manager.
Yeah, and then, since everything's dynamic, they're not gonna have the data to kind of manage it well.
It seems that there's a, like what George Washington allegedly did, it seems like most humans are not able to fire themselves. You're not sure. Able to like...
Yeah, you're right.
Ultimately,
yeah.
Be a check on your own power, but that's not, if I was creating a human, it's like that's not an obvious bug of the system that we would not be able to fire ourselves to know when we have. I mean, it seems like that's something you have to know always. Like that's something I often wonder: is like, am I wrong about this?
Well, this is what we talked about earlier. What are the safety valves?
Yeah,
to make sure that okay, if I am incorrect or my knowledge is finite, Plato's cave kind of thing. What mechanisms are in place that my mistake or limited information isn't going to have deleterious consequences? And North Korea does not really have that. And as a result, they had polio in the 90s.